Good afternoon, Prasoon ji. You are getting my voice?
Yes, good afternoon, Ajay ji.
Good afternoon, and good afternoon, all the participants. So, I had requested Sri Prasoon ji way back, I think 2 weeks back, to conduct a session for the students and faculty members both on economic conditions in the current situation and under impact of COVID-19 specifically. So he was kind enough to accept the invitation, and today he is here to deliberate on these subjects. He has been interacting on different forums also and different government bodies also. Rather, he was also having session at one of the chapters of United Nations too, and I have been following him very closely. He was kind enough to share a few videos and few photographs also to me. So I think this is going to be the right platform to understand about the future economic conditions post COVID, especially from a person who is otherwise expert on this subject and who will be rather focusing light on this subject. He has been in touch with many other experts in this area, and his expressions, his ideas, his deliberation on this subject will definitely be very important for all of us. So let us move towards this session, because present session is only for 30-35 minutes, then we will have to recontinue. So we don't would like to waste the time. So Prasoon ji, you can start your session, I think.
Okay, thanks Ajay ji, and thanks other faculty members, and welcome to all the students. First of all, thanks Ajay ji for inviting me. So I'll just give you a brief, like I was working on these kind of economic impact papers for various governments, including Indian government. So let me check if I can share my screen with you. I'll just a brief of my is it visible? Can you see some?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yes,
okay,
sir.
So I'll just give a snapshot of my current report. So may I know the background of the students, so in which class they are and when they are expecting to graduate?
Right,
they are,
sir.
PGDM first year, so they have completed 3 trimester now. They will be moving to second year.
Okay, so then I think for them it will be a mix and maybe a jackpot also, because next year India is projected by IMF to have like 7.4% of GDP growth. These are the figures as per IMF report, the recent one. In present financial year, only two countries, that is India and China, are showing positive growth, and India is leading that. But in next year, when this batch will be out and completed their courses, so the India will be seeing around 7.4% of GDP growth. So that's good thing. But in terms of how our economy is now, this shows our India's export and import, which you can see that there is a decline both in export as well as import. And due to that, the trade deficit has also been decreased, and this has also impacted the job market as well. And this is, till March, the figures are, which is shared by the various ministries. So as a PGDM students, I think the best options for them will be like if they wanted to pursue as an entrepreneur or a startup, because in coming days, whether it's banks or Indian governments, they will promote or finance more of a startup business rather than just job market. And in terms of just major commodities, which will tell them which industry is growing and which is going. So you can see the most of the commodities are down and negative. Only iron ore, which we sell as raw material, is there. It's around 60% of growth in comparison to last year. So overall, it's a decline phase for India, as everyone knows. But the positive sides in Indian economy now is one, pharmaceutical, which is showing some, you know, very good supplies, as India is supplying around 55 countries. The two, one is a generic medicine and then the HCQ medicine. So the students which are focusing on pharma side or medicine side or technology related to medical health or medical equipments, they'll be, you know, in more demand. Now, in terms of FDI, I just wanted to show you a small discussion. This is we recently had. Is it audible to you?
Yes, yes, very clear.
Yes, sir.
The sound of the video is not audible.
Oh, let me just. Have a move from India in terms of.
Is it audible?
India has taken up safeguard,
yeah.
The political.
Yeah.
Talking about safeguards.
I think we can select where economically or politically we need the investment, whether it's from China. Because right now you see that China controls around 80% of global supply chain, and there is a disruption, and easily India can fit in like 10 to 20% of that share could come to India. You can see that India become a pharmacy of the whole world. We are supplying various medicines to almost all the major countries. But the API or raw material for these supplies are majorly from China. So we need to balance this. So this is a very strategic and clever move from India. In terms of state, UP has taken a proactive approach. They should also start engaging with not only Chinese, they should also engage with American companies, because what China did is like 3M, which used to make masks and other pharmaceutical supplies, their manufacturing hub was in China, and then when they wanted to manufacture and supply their products which are to US, they were stopped by Chinese government. So they are also not very happy of having their manufacturing base in China. They're also looking for some other base as well. So that is also an opportunity. And as well, the Japan, which announced $2.2 trillion package to move their companies out of China, there also we can leverage PM through this personal rapport with the Prime Minister of Japan.
Yes.
So, this is about the recent FDI changes which Indian government did. And there's another initiative by Government of India. They are talking to around 100 plus companies which wanted to move their manufacturing base from China. And also the Indian Commerce and Niti Aayog has approach some Japanese companies as well to move their base. So the students who are in, you know, more towards, you know, foreign policy or international relationship, they will be in good shape when they finish their PGDM. And students which also have some understanding of their languages, whether it's Japanese or Chinese, will also benefit from these moves. And in terms of, you know, impact on job, this was an article published by me in a magazine called Organizer. So there was a prediction from Asian Development Bank that if India could have contained in stage one or stage two, they would have, you know, saved around 940,000 jobs and around 30,000 million USD of loss in the GDP. But although we have slightly passed this stage, and we have to wait that till next lockdown, are we able to contain this virus? This will, you know, define the future trajectory of our economy, as well as other aspects related to it, whether it's job, whether it's investments. So this is a brief of economy which I wanted to give. Like I gave overall the global economy figures from IMF and our export and import, and specifically our exports, which increases the or put money in the job market. And then the recent FDI changes, why did happen? This happen, and this was because of the recent news about HDFC stake taken by a Chinese bank, although it's very minor one, but still Indian government thought that it is good to have a cautious approach because all the share market is down, and they wanted to have a vigilant eye on foreign investors. But other facts about foreign investment, specifically Chinese investment, out of our 30 unicorns, that is 1 billion worth startups, in 18, there is a Chinese investment. So whether you call it Paytm, Ola, Zomato, Big Basket, so they already have a big investment from China. And on the other hand, Indian government has, asked these startups to keep paying their employees. So they will, face challenges because now they can't raise money from their Chinese investment, but they have to pay to their employees. They also have to pay some rents. So this is overall, a pitch from my side. Now I'm open for discussion or any kind of, questions.
Okay. Director sir, should I take up the open forum now? Okay. Director sir, should I take up the open forum now?
I think Director sir has quit the session because of some technical issues.
Okay, Arpana, if you are there, then you can just start. In the meanwhile, I'll just talk to sir.
So there's a question one student want to understand. Basically, he has also given his opinion that American technology companies, firm Apple, Microsoft and Google have reportedly looked to move manufacturing away from China. So will China allow, is it possible for them to set up the hub to other growing countries easily, as China's world's production hub around 28.4% according to 2019 data?
I think it's a good question. Definitely, China will do all sort of things to stop them. And China has a might of investing or giving subsidies to them, because China have around 3 trillion of 3 trillion USD foreign reserves. And as per the IMF, the manufacturing facilities declined when we compare from global financial crisis. In China was just 11%. So it's not that difficult for China to ramp up their manufacturing capacity as of now. But because of this anti-China sentiments rising globally, so there do hope, hope for Indian, government to attract some of these manufacturing units to India.
Director sir has joined.
So considering the condition of economy nowadays, because we are, of course, dealing with the students and a lot of queries they have regarding their job opportunities, impact on their job opportunities. So what would you like to say, and how would you motivate the students regarding that?
I think for the students who are graduating next year, they don't have to worry. And the education should not be seen in short term when you are calculating your return of investment. It's like a lifetime return on this education. But I will strongly suggest that most of them should consider to be an entrepreneur or a startup. That will be, much more rewarding because as you see, the RBI and other banks, they are pushing the liquidity, but most of the benefit will transfer to the startups, because I'm also mentoring 5 startups. One of my startups got President of India Award. That is a nasal filter. I think if for the mask, you may have used in that. So we are getting very good support from the government side. So I would recommend these students to pursue entrepreneurship for their future job perspectives.
Okay. Also, sir, many of our industries are dependent on China for the raw materials and supply chain. So how the FDI restrictions will have impact on trade issues with China?
I think even with this restriction, you know, this month only, we imported around 340 tons of medical supply. We sent around 24 flights, to China. And for our pharmaceutical industry, we highly depend on Chinese APIs. But we started working to find alternatives, and few of the big pharmaceuticals, they started procuring from local API suppliers also, although the capacity is less, but they are ramping up.
Okay. Again, one question is coming regarding job itself. So at this situation, and the students are fresher, and which sector they should look for, basically, where they that would be easier for them and comfortable for them as well to get the job sector?
I think for Indians, the topmost will be the technology sector, because a lot of work from home and technology dependence will be there. And other important aspect I wanted to share with all the students, which is not widely discussed, is due to this COVID-19, Brookings Institute predicted that there will be a death of around 3.6 million people as of now. And majority of these deaths are in G20 nations. So the disease persons are knowledge workers. So that knowledge workers can be researchers in European countries and other developed countries, some innovators or some funded projects from various institutes. So the students should also look into pursuing research and innovative projects based out of the G20 nations, because of this anti-China sentiment. The Chinese students will face some challenges to get these jobs or research openings or projects. Previously, Chinese were among number one, whether it's US courses or funded project research, or in European Union as well, when you talk about international students. So this is another opportunity for Indian students and freshers if they want to pursue their career in research, and that research to be in very high tech field and innovative field, and also in healthcare as well. Other I talk about technology, and the third is healthcare related industries will be there for next 2 to 3 years. There'll be demand of basic healthcare and hygiene supplies. So I think these three industries they should focus on.
Okay. Sir, I can see that remaining time is 2 or 3 minutes, but we'll be requesting you to please reconnect us back with using the same ID, because this is a 40-minute session in one go. So in case if we get disconnected, please reconnect us using the same link. One more area, because you have worked with a lot of government agencies as well. So how do you think government can support SMEs at this stage?
For SMEs, we are expecting another package or so from government. They are, I think, waiting this lockdown to be closed. And although from RBI side, they already pushed the liquidity. But we are expecting like GST waivers and tax subsidies. And also if you are setting up a manufacturing unit, easy loans. So we are waiting for a wholesome financial package for MSME as well as the whole industry from Finance Minister.
And any, sir, your perception in retail sector, because a lot of opportunities initially were there in retail sector as well. So impact and opportunities now.
I think retail sector will be a mixed response, because as per the consumer side, they'll be more cautious in spending and buying. Because of unpredictability in economy, the consumers will wait and watch to buy any non-essential items. So this will be like a mixed response. We have to wait and watch about FMCG or retail sector.
Sir, a lot of talks regarding organic farming was going on, and India and other countries are also moving towards that. So opportunity in organic farming, I mean, how now, as we know that a lot of due to this climatic condition, and everyone is realizing that we have so much disturbed the nature. So people would definitely be realizing to some